doesn't sound good. I think there's gonna be much left when the smoke clears. Nobody's walking away from that. Well, that took down a few. What are you all peeping at, you fucking slack-jawed sons of bitches? Now that was a fucking big one. This shit is fucking
crazy. I'm just getting started.
That was a fucking drag out. That's the end of that. Don't tell me I don't have dough. Well, that took down a few. Nice. This'll put me in the fight.
Take it, just like I did last time.
Wait, Oliver, you fell. You just gotta find the fuel can. Maybe I should keep those fucking crusties off my back for a bit.
Kaboom.
First time I fired a machine gun, a little more than a punk kid. Got another fuel can. Drink to our victory. How's that for a one-punch knockout?
Double points!
I think the odds are starting to move in our favor. Next time you croaked, fucker. What you started.
Kick your
run. We could do with more hits like that one. That doesn't sound good. I'll deal with you in a minute. You sure this is uncontaminated? You can't be too careful.
My name is Stanley Ferguson. was a guard at Alcatraz from 1933 to 1942. Today, I'm going to give you some insight into one of the more interesting tales from the prison's history. Over the decades, Alcatraz has seen more than its fair share of daring escape attempts. However, few were as audacious as the one undertaken by four inmates on New Year's Eve, 1933. Thought to be the brainchild of an inmate by the name of Albert Arlington, the outrageous scheme was as unlikely as its mastermind. It's believed that Arlington, aka the Weasel, somehow convinced three other inmates that he had devised a foolproof plan to escape the rock. It was a plan that would see them literally taking to the skies on a makeshift aircraft of Arlington's own design. Just how the Weasel managed to convince these hardened criminals that such a plan was even possible remains a mystery to this day. What is known is that no such plane was ever built. Instead, the group's plans for freedom soon descended into bitter arguments and infighting. With the plan falling apart, anger and frustration would ultimately lead to a brutal altercation between the misguided Arlington and his former co-conspirators.
Don't mind if I fucking do.
Only with makeshift weapons, Finn O'Leary, Sal DeLuca, and Billy Hanson lured the unsuspecting Arlington to the roof, where they intended to exact a bloody and violent revenge. And so it was here, beneath the dark and stormy winter skies, that the hapless Arlington met his grisly end, bleeding to death on the cold concrete roof. For their participation in the murder, the three collaborators were sent to death by electric chair. Justice came swiftly. On the morning of January 19th, 1934, the execution order was carried out.
Who's palling around with the Weasel?